All right, folks, how you doing? So today we're going to talk about three phyla. We're going to talk about Porifera, the sponges. We're going to talk about Cnidaria, the jellyfish, and then Platyhelminthes, the tapeworms and flatworms. So we'll start out with the sponges. They're very simple animals. You can find Porifera on page 52. The sponges have no true tissue, so no muscle tissue or nervous tissue or anything like that. Instead, they have just a cellular level of organization. So they do have a few different types of cells that do different things. We'll talk about them in just a second, but no tissue level organization. No planes of symmetry, so they're asymmetrical, and no complete digestive tract or anything like that. So I've got a couple of examples for sponges. This sponge here, you can see this, you know, feels like a sponge you might use in the shower. One of the things you can see on the outside are these holes. So those are called the porosites. That's where water flows into the sponge. I'm gonna switch to this one real quick. Here you can see the porosites on the outside as well. The central portion of the sponge is hollow. So that's called the spongocele. And in that spongocele, there are special types of cells called choanocytes. There's a good diagram on page 52 that shows those. Choanocytes are little cells with a flagellum. And as those flagella beat, they create a current to pull water through the sponge. So it comes in through the porosites into that central cavity called the spongocele, and then up out through the osculum. That's that large hole at the top. In the middle, kind of in between, there are other cells called amoebocytes. They produce this tough substance, either spongin, which is kind of soft, or they can make other things like spicules, which are kind of pokey. Those amoebocytes also help with digestion. They help move nutrients around the sponge's body. But again, no digestive tract in these guys, and really just a cellular level of organization.